On the 6th of February, all schools across the country are expected to open for the commencement of a first school term. However, many have already opened and are receiving learners in preparation for the official school opening. School owners and administrators have been tasked to observe all the guidelines issued by the Ministry of Education to ensure the safety of learners while they are at school.
All schools are reminded to review their security emergency preparations in case of where an emergency has arisen, like a school fire, a collapse of a building, and so the security emergency preparations are very important. And then also getting to review the school visitor procedures and how to access classrooms and certain premises within the school should be done with a lot of priority.
Likewise, parents have been tipped on how best they can ensure the safety of their learners as they travel to and from school.
To help our children memorize contact information now that they are going back to school, for a child to know their full name, address, home number, and how to use a phone where necessary, and instances, it's also important that a school has a record of emergency contact details that includes the office phone, the cell phones, the home phones. They should make sure that the child at whatever stage knows which adult to contact in case of an emergency. Parents, as we take children to school, please let's teach them to be alert and vigilant.
All PSV operators are advised not to load any excess in those vehicles. Don't rush the students when they are offloading their luggages from those cars. And those taxis with rails on top, make sure you don't load any load that is above the height of the rail. You tend to load those taxis as if you're loading lorries.
From the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety, the latest report indicates that at least 134 people were killed in road crashes in the past 2 weeks. Farida Nampima, the traffic police spokesperson, reveals that a total of 705 road accidents happened on the roads in the last 2 weeks. In these accidents, 134 people were killed, while 564 were seriously injured. This brings the total number of people who died in road accidents in the past 1 month to 269, while over 1,000 sustained life-threatening injuries.
Most of you don't want to repair your cars. They break down in the roads. Imagine the size of the roads we have in this country. Then your vehicle breaks down in the middle of the road. Why do you expect other people to pass? You don't even put warning signs. People come and ram into those vehicles. When people try to dodge those broken down vehicles, they lose control of the cars. Other people, your vehicles are not in good condition. It's time to break the car fails to break.
From the Kampala metropolitan area, police in Kawempe Division are investigating a case in which a 27-year-old man lured children into his house and defiled them. The suspect reportedly tricked the children with simple snacks.
It is alleged that the suspect, in respect of during these holidays, in respect of 2 months, he defiled 4 children, 3 of whom were boys and 1 girl. The victims were identified, their statements taken, and also examined, and it was confirmed that there was an intrusion.
Also, police in Arua are investigating a case in which a 25-year-old businessman died in a lodge. The deceased had reportedly checked into the lodge with his girlfriend, but moments later, the lady informed the lodge administrator that he had died.
Our police, of course, opened a death inquiry when this matter came up to establish circumstances under which Ewan Ali Mustafa, aged 25, a businessman of Ozu Cell in Arua City, died following allegations that he died of a cardiac arrest. during a love-making session with his girlfriend called Adania Ratro.
Rachel Nashwala reporting for the news.